versus Toad, Peach versus Lucario.
Yep.
Hero.
Okay. So this is definitely a little bit something I wasn't expecting. Only because the last time that I remember seeing this type of game was actually when, Vivi played against Ling Ling. Now, we already know how good Ling Ling is, but this is going to be a little bit hard because y'all already know about Peach and Swords. Those two don't go together.
Yeah, and certainly Peach has the ability to get in on the characters, and once she's in, she does crazy things. That's bad. Vivi is also very good at this game, and that is a quick zero to death. Certainly one of our very strong hero players in New York, as we have both him and Silvio, both very, very good hero players.
Period.
And it is definitely tough if you're not familiar with these matchups, if you're coming out of state. I believe Toad is New Jersey, correct?
No, Toad is Chicago.
Chicago, so not even further. So if you're coming from out of state, not that many places have as many hero players as New York does. It's definitely an unfamiliar matchup for many people, especially if your character doesn't have the range. Like Peach can be really tough against a character that really does put on that pressure from a distance like Hero does.
The kind of thing is, too, I definitely feel like we're going to need to see a little bit more situations where Toad actually catches a lot of landings, because we are playing against Hero and people don't know how bad it is for Hero to land. Just get Hero out of the air. Peach does have really good anti-air at that. I mean, we could just see a lot of situations where, Toad just makes it extremely hard for Vivi to land.
Ooh, yeah, that much is true. Hero oftentimes does have to come down with a hitbox. Over here, though, we're seeing the ledge drop coming out from Vivi. Has been so good at the ledge so far. Already got that first stuck at ledge with Snooze. Quick heal. Gets back to that magic percent. And we are looking for
something.
holding center stage is really well, though. Missed it on the parry punish. But Vivi getting back to stage. Ooh, looking for a sneaky fair with Acceleradle. Looking to go low, but again, Peach is a tough character to edgeguard. That hitbox is so huge above her. Okay.
And even the kind of thing is here, too, is that, the kind of difference in Hero's players that we see is that, Vivi is one of those Hero players is that he kind of just takes what he knows from, Lucario, being very good at ledge trapping. And that's just kind of the things that you see a lot of. He actually uses his tools really well. Like that F tilt right there, going to take that stock at 160.
That was so good. I want to point that out. The spacing on that was perfect. Peach side B is actually really big. That was a huge hitbox.
Mm-hmm.
You needed perfect spacing with that disjointed hitbox that Hero has with the shield on F tilt to really get that. So it was really nice time, really nice space by Vivi on that move to get that stock. And Vivi showing really his prowess as one of New York's best players here.
Mm-hmm. And the kind of thing is, too, is that, turn up.
Oh, we're back.
Not entirely just yet, is that, we've kind of just seen, Toad struggle at just picking normal getup or using one of the many, options that they actually have, afforded to Peach. Because Peach has float, they have jump, they have a lot of things that, it's kind of just like Vivi already knows what this character can do, and he's kind of just, doing.
Oh, are we dead? We're not dead. Vivi opts to go for a little bit of a safer option. And now we're definitely dead. I would have liked to have seen a crit. Would have been fun. I like that sound effect for this character especially. But,
it's so sad.
Yes, right now, New York's own Vivi doing very well so far. Dominant game number one, 2 stock. Definitely a matchup that it seems like Toad is unfamiliar with, which cannot blame them. This is definitely a matchup that is not around many other places. And we're going to see if there's going to be some adaptations. I imagine we're going to a small stage. Are we going to a small stage? Oh, we're switching completely to Trainer, which I do get. Much easier to get in on this character as Trainer than it is Peach.
Mm-hmm.
Great spacing right there by Vivi on that.
And this is definitely a character that they kind of have as, almost secondary because, if they feel like they can't actually do anything with Peach, then they're going to just have to switch it up. I mean, this definitely affords a lot more options to Toad only because, a little bit less obvious defensive options, a little bit more, playing just better in neutral because, Squirtle has a very good neutral.
Yeah.
And it kind of just a lot more afforded to actually punishing, Hero for doing something very bad on shield. But I feel like what we're seeing right now is that Toad is being a lot more aggressive.
Yeah.
And it's not really working out because a lot of this movement camping, I guess I would say, is something that Vivi has been doing. They almost stood at 0% for almost the whole time.
Yeah,
so.
And I think you bring up a great point there, Jazzy, and that's that despite the fact that Chota has gotten more aggressive, Vivi has gotten more defensive and has kind of sat back, said, hey, you're coming to me. And Vivi did a great job of keeping center stage in that game number one, but the adaptation from Vivi has almost come out instantly where we said, okay, you're going to play aggressively, you're going to run at me with Squirtle, you're going to try and mix me up with Razor Leaf and stuff as Ivysaur. I'm going to stay center stage and good luck. And the ledge jumps have been so strong.
I mean, this is just something that Vivi is extremely good at. Vivi is extremely good at getting a lot of these ledge trap situations. They don't even need to understand how,
big tomahawk,
how many other, tools that you may have at your disposal, because a lot of the tools that we've been seeing that have been getting called out has been a lot of these jumps, rolls, a lot of just like, very mix up options that, people might have that Vivi just covers with a lot of these big tools that he has.
Yeah. And overall, it's just like, it's been so tough. I think, and similarly to Peach, this character does have trouble landing. Pokemon Trainer even more so than Peach. And it has certainly been that getting out of disadvantage has been really tough for Toad. Vivi's just kind of been dominating at the ledge, been dominating in the air to air battle. And I think we need to see some adaptation coming out from either of these players. Or rather from Toad, if we're going to see a change in that. Ooh, missed grab right there. Now we're seeing Toad having a solid job and advantage. Looking for that downer, not going to get it. And so I still catch that get up, and that's huge for Toad.
All right. And kind of what I'm hoping to see a little bit more is just for Toad to play a little bit more of neutral, because that's what Squirtle is best at. People really struggle against actually having to deal with a small character like Pichu, per se, like Pikachu, that just solely rely on playing neutral and just getting their, advantages, their combos going, and just really being good at just, maybe not dying. I don't know.
but landing there, super tough. Again, a little bit of a misstep on the landing, and Vivi taking full advantage with that F tilt. Going to be a stock that psyched up F tilt is going to be so strong. Almost getting Ivysaur as Ivysaur came back to stage. That Razor Leaf though puts Toad in a good situation. Psybe does so much damage. Ooh, and this is looking super tough again for Toad. And that grab. We're dead. Ooh. We're not dead. Okay.
That was looking a little scary for a bit. I mean,
Oceleratl. We can get Charizard. Oh, the spacing was perfect. Vivi just staying center stage, waiting for that side B to come out. Kind of, I think, an admission of defeat at that point. It was really dominant performance by Vivi. Methodical, even. It almost felt like the situation just kept repeating themselves. Just putting Toad at ledge. Oh, that is unfortunate, actually. Can we run that replay back, Devin? I want to just pause right here. Boom. Watson's Charizard here, folks. Goes closer to ledge. Let's move forward. Duh. Charizard's definitely gonna grab the. No, we're not grabbing ledge. We're not grabbing ledge.
He looked like he really wanted to take a chomp out of that ledge.
Yeah.
And Charizard looked really hungry right there, but unfortunately, we can't eat. Toad didn't get to eat like they wanted to eat. They wanted to do the most. They wanted to eat Vivi up, but unfortunately, he got ate up. And unfortunately, we're just gonna have to say.
Vivi's nice. Vivi's nice.
That is absolutely true.
Ledge traps were so strong. Mm-hmm. I have to stress that more than anything. The ledge traps were so good.
We got to tell y'all, because this is something that has been very consistent with Vivi. Vivi has been perfect, amazing, wonderful at all of the things that, he's been really kind of implementing with Lucario, with, Hero. They have been super on the grind, especially just with a lot of what they've been doing. It's just so amazing. We love the talent here.